I checked in the rehab for alcohol and marijuana, but it was way deeper than that. It was me wanting to be cool. It was around friends. The environment I grew in was very competitive. I played sports, I was in extracurricular activities. And the environment where I lived at, there was a lot of racism too. And when I say racism, I don't mean just necessarily black and white. I'm talking about class distinction, I'm talking about money. And when you're a kid, you don't know any better. So you're just trying to do the best you can. But when I look back, I was always trying to compete. So my self-esteem as a child was real low. And I always felt not worthy. And I think that's what led me to want to try to fit in with the other kids instead of just being who I was. So real early, I felt different. And instead of embracing that different, I tried to be like everything else. Who I am matters. I am valuable for who I am. I was put here for a reason. And I wish looking back, I could have just embraced who I was, but there's a pressure to try to be like everybody else and fit in. Because if you're different, and we go through it now with the system, right? A kid doesn't learn the same way as everybody else, and he's an artist. That's pushed away. We want you to be this, or we want you to be that. So that kid starts feeling different. So there was a lot of pressure put on me early, and instead of me embracing who I was, I caved to that. And I think because I felt different and because my household was different, I wanted to be like everybody else. You normally don't start out with heroin in your neck. That's not how it starts out. But see, the problem is once the brain kicks, some of us just have that to where we can't stop. So my point is, I understand that some of you have to do it for anxiety, but there's so many other tools besides drugs and alcohol that you can use. So why not try eating healthy, working out, reading, something that is a healthy habit? Why do we feel that we gotta go right to drugs and alcohol? Is it because it's so socialized? Is it because so many people do it? How come nobody thinks, you know what, I don't feel right today. Maybe I should go work out or try a new running habit or try a new hobby? Or why don't our brains go there? I don't know if that's a societal issue or what. But I think that if you look at more healthy habits, you're gonna find better ways to relieve that stress and anxiety. I've never met nobody healthy and spiritual and in a good, positive place and productive, not just physically, but also spiritually, that have to put something in their body to feel different. I've never met nobody like that. The healthiest and happiest people don't need to use anything.